stashed his trash in Ecuador, bought a good suit of clothes, flew on up to Mexico, standing by the shore, waiting for some mystery man to pay him for his time, but thinking about all the money he'd made couldn't help to ease his mind. Havana daydreaming, boy, he's just dreaming.
It's Chris from NiceTightAsh.com bringing you another cigar review today. And today it'll be the Padilla Achilles, the Edición Especial 2006, featuring a Nicaraguan Corojo wrapper. Filler tobacco is Nicaraguan, Honduran, and Dominican, just a blend. These cigars are sold in bundles of 20 for right around 50 bucks. You can find them online, so pretty decent deal on that. It's smoking the Robusto today. It's 5 inches long with a 54 ring gauge, pretty stout cigar, and you can really tell it touching it. I mean, it's solid. Got a lot of tobacco packed up in the cigar. A really nice caramel colored wrapper. Quite a few veins running through it, but there is one vein laying under the surface here that, you know, perhaps could cause some issues. But other than that, I think the cigar looks like it's been constructed really nicely. Double cap. The aroma is really reminiscent of a horse barn. I mean, just really light. I mean, it's not really potent, but it's light. Got a lot of the hay or straw. And a little bit of slight aroma of manure. So usually I love that in the pre-light aroma of a cigar. I think it shows some real promise. At least in my experience. So anyways, it's a good day out here. Really nice weather for winter. So I thought I'd get out here and do a review. So let me go ahead and cut and fire it up, and I'll be back in a little bit. Let you know how the Padilla Achilles is going. All right. I'm just a little ways into my Padilla Achilles so far. And I had to come back and talk about it because it was right off the light. Just wonderful flavors. Definitely pick out the leather in it. There's some spice in there, really muted spice, kind of like nutmeg. In fact, it's exactly like nutmeg to me. And that those pre-light aromas I got of the hay and straw, you can definitely pick that out in the smoke as well. The draw is great. It's producing a lot of smoke. And in fact, something else I've noticed about this cigar is a lot of times I have a difficult time actually smelling the cigar that I'm smoking. And today I can. And that's even weirder to me being outside, not in the garage like I usually am. But I can definitely pick up the aroma on this. It's really nice. It's light, kind of an airy aroma to it. But you can kind of pick out those pre-light aromas. You can definitely still smell here as it's a lit cigar, so definitely the hay and straw, not so much the manure, but definitely that light barn stall kind of or horse stall, barnyard, whatever, aroma. So, I mean, not very far into this cigar so far, and it's really striking my fancy so far. Maybe it's because we finally got some nice weather, I don't know, but anyways, let me go ahead and smoke some more, back in a little bit, and let you know how things continue. Okay, I'm about getting close to a third of the way through my Padilla Achilles, and so far I still think it's going really well. The burn probably isn't as straight on as it had been in the past, but it's still doing well. The flavors are changing up a little bit. I'm still picking up hints of that. Straw and hay. The leatheriness, I think, it's still there, but I'm starting to pick up a lot of like toasted nuts, or roasted peanuts, something like that. It's been a really nice cigar so far. It's still drawing well. You know, it's got a really nice tight ash on it. Really nice tight ash on it. I don't know. Just, it's going really well. And this is a cigar I've had on and off. I've never bought a whole bunch of them, but I've seemed to have picked them up in either samplers or cigar bombs from folks. And they've always been okay to me. But you know, this one, I don't know. I don't know how long I've had this one in the humidor. Or maybe it's this particular size. Although I think I've had more of the Robustos, but I don't know. This one's just really hitting the spot. Anyways, let me go ahead and smoke some more. I'll try to figure out what's going on here and be back in a little bit and let you know how things continue to progress. Okay, I'm about halfway through my Padilla Achilles. And still going very nicely. I forgot to mention in the last part that the spice is still there. It's more present through the retrohale now than anything. The toasted nut flavors are really picking up. Still get a little bit of that, little bit of that leatheriness. Hay and straw, definitely. Just a really nice cigar. The flavors seem to be meshing very well. It's medium-bodied. It's not like packed full of flavor or anything. It's just a really nice, smooth cigar so far. And I'm really, really enjoying it today. So, and like I said, I've had some more in the past. And not to say I didn't enjoy those, but I just don't remember them being as good as this one today. So, anyways, let me go ahead and smoke some more. And I'll come back in a little bit and let you know how things are going.